Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. You are dearly welcome to Jungle's Entertainment. Here we give you silly news of what is changing in Nigeria and Africa and the world at large. Please do to hit the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like. And feel free to share this video on any of your social media platform. Nigerian footballer Kelechi Iheanacho, he's been doing very well. He's been doing very well as a superb player and also as a striker in Leicester City. Kelechi Iheanacho makes Premier League history as first player to score on all 7 days of the week in the same season. That is huge. Congratulations to you, Kelechi. The Super Eagle and Leicester City superstar Kelechi Iheanacho made history on Tuesday night, May 18, 2021, as the first Premier League striker to score on all 7 days of the week in a single season. The informed Nigerian striker was on target for Leicester City as they suffered a 2-1 defeat to Chelsea to achieve the milestone. The 24-year-old now boasts of 12 goals in 24 Premier League appearances so far in the 2020/2021 season. Overall, he is Leicester's highest goal scorer in the competitions with 16 goals. Congratulations to you, Kelechi. You've been doing very well. And there's this video that has been trending. His colleagues and friends, they were asking him to cut soap for them because he's been doing very well. You know, for someone to ask you to cut soap, that means you have been achieving a milestone, just like Kelechi. He has been doing very well in the Super Eagles and also in Leicester City. We're just watching a video of his friend asking him to cut soap for him.
Why is your waka like this?
My waka don't change.
Waka don't change. Wow, I don't use every platform to ask you for soap. You know, go give me. Petty apple now. You know, go help your brother.
I don't change. I know they use soap again. I shower gel.
Shower gel. I shower gel if they use.
Yeah, I don't change.
Petty shower gel now. Make I come collect.
You know, wait till the shower gel what they use now. Yeah? You know, before everybody. For everybody. So I will put smoke for your hand. You take a go for shower.
You go do me like that.
For
how many months or how many days?
Huh?
How many months?
Just for 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Yeah, just for 2 weeks.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just for.
So Kelechi, I beg, cut soap for your colleagues so that, I mean, they'll start scoring goals like you. 7 goals in 7 days. I mean, to score on all 7 days in a season, that is huge. That is huge. I bet cut soap for your friend. But according to Kelechi, in the video, he said he doesn't use soap anymore. He uses shower gel to take his bath. And he has promised his colleagues that he will press his squeeze on for them to take a shower, to maybe wash their hair so that they'll be able to score goals like him. Well, kudos to you, Kelechi. Kudos to you. And as you can see, Kelechi, he is now a senior man. In waka don't change. You know, he's doing his thing. We've said a little about football, let us move on to the music industry. Techno. The video gives credit to Techno for producing and writing the hit single If. That song was actually produced and written by Techno. Techno, also known as Alaji, Techno has gotten recognized by the Recording Industry Association of America, RIAA, for his work on Davido's gold certified single If. Davido made this known via his Instagram story post, where he shared a photo of the plaque while tagging Techno with a love sign emoji before his username. Techno is credited for producing and writing the hit single If and suggesting that Davido record the song as his. Congratulations to you, Techno. You did very well. Congratulations to you, Davido, too. That song is huge. If that song blew so high that R. Kelly did a remix of the song. If that song is huge. Congratulations to you, Davido. Congratulations to you, Techno. You guys have been doing very well. You've been placing Nigeria on the world map. We really appreciate you guys for that. Nengi Rebecca Hanson just dropped a message recently. She said, "I love being a pretty girl with a pretty attitude." We know Nengi that went to Big Brother. I mean, she was hot. I mean, she was this calm, cool, and collected girl. She doesn't talk much, and she has a thing. She's so beautiful. She's hot. She's pretty. She has this light skin. And from a video I did recently, I did an analysis on Nengi. Apart from being SSA to the governor of Bayelsa State, she's a half caste. Her father is from the UK, while her mom is from Nigeria. And Nengi just dropped a message recently that she loved being pretty, a pretty girl with a pretty attitude. Nengi is actually pretty. Recently, she went to the United Kingdom. She just went there for, you know, a visit, and she didn't inform her fans. But guess what? Her fans welcomed her with a bucket of money. They gave her pounced. I mean, she was surprised. She was like, I didn't tell you guys I was coming. I just came to the United Kingdom, and you guys just gathered and gave me this huge gift. She was so happy. She was so excited. Nengi actually has huge number of fans out there, and she's doing very well. She came out of Big Brother, and she bought a house in Lagos. She's this calm, cool, and collected person. And she's hot. She's beautiful. And Nengi has said it with her mind that she loves being a pretty girl. She's actually a pretty girl. Well, we don't know who will marry this girl. Big Brother Nigeria is one hot show. People are hustling to go into the house. Because, you know, if you go into that house, you can't come back broke. Never. You can never come back broke. I mean, you've been having deals. You've been signing deals with people. Even if you don't win, I mean, you will definitely come out with money. Even if you don't come out with money from the house, you'll be making money when you leave the house, because I mean, you've been signing deals, and we'll be hoping for the next season. The next season will be premiering very soon, in a few months. We can't wait to see the next Big Brother housemates. We can't wait to see the next Big Brother housemates, and we can't wait to see who become the next millionaire in Nigeria. Let's talk about our Grammy Award winner and brother, Burna Boy. Someone actually dropped a message and said, Burna Boy will soon leave Twitter Niger for Una. Burna Boy replied to this message and said, me we no even be Nigerian artist. Someone said, Petu replied to Burna Boy and said, but you dey promote African culture and you dey deny your own motherland. All na showbiz as usual. LMAO. We all know Burna Boy has been promoting African culture. He doesn't do foreign songs, no. He does Afro fusion. He does his own brand of Afro, and it's been huge. It's been hitting. That's why he won the Grammy. And from what he said, he'll be dropping his next album in August. And this is May 2021. Burna Boy replied to this tweet from the person who said that Burna Boy is promoting African culture and that he's denying his motherland at the same time. Burna Boy said, I am from here and I live here because I love my house and my people. In no pass like that. I don't make money from Nigeria, now only cruise day here. Well, someone actually replied to Burna Boy and said, thunder fire your lies. The one you make from Wike on your home coming, now waiting. Odogu, the biggest liar. Burna Boy actually replied to this message and said, lol, I didn't get a dime. Only the artists who honored me by performing at my homecoming concert were paid. Get your facts right. And according to what Burna Boy's manager and mother said, that Burna Boy wasn't paid. He wasn't given a dime by Governor Wike, but all those that came to perform on Burna Boy's homecoming concert, they got money, but Burna Boy wasn't paid. Well, we've heard it from the desk of Burna Boy has said it, that he doesn't make money from Nigeria, that he's making money outside the country. What are your thoughts on that? Please don't forget to drop your comments below. Cryptocurrency. Nigerians, you know, there's this, the Central Bank of Nigeria came up recently and said people shouldn't invest in cryptocurrency. That they banned, yeah, they actually banned cryptocurrency in Nigeria. But there's this thing that has been trending. Elon Musk came, and so many people have invested in cryptocurrency, not because of the cryptocurrency, but because of Elon Musk. You know, Elon Musk is one of the richest persons on earth. He's this number two when it comes to Forbes list. He's the second richest person on earth. Someone actually dropped a message regarding his investment in cryptocurrency. He said, the person's name is Rolling Peace. He said, dear Satoshi and Elon Musk, I didn't have any intention to invest in Bitcoin. At this moment, I keep that little change in my wallet because I didn't want to spend it. It was meant for my house rent and school fees. Be human to hike the price of BTC to 68,000 so I can withdraw the initial amount I deposited. I swear to God, I will withdraw it immediately. It increased to 68,000. Wallahi, I will. What will you gain if I drop out of school and have no roof over my head because of Bitcoin? You know, there's this thing regarding Bitcoin. It's always advisable that if you are investing in Bitcoin, you should use money you are ready to spend, money you are ready to throw away. Let me phrase it out here, money you are ready to throw away. But this guy's own is like a huge risk, using your school fees and house rent to invest in Bitcoin. And Regarding this Bitcoin, someone actually dropped a message. I Charles Link. He said someone said Bitcoin is an advanced Ponzi scheme. Elon Musk, see what you have caused. People have been investing in Bitcoin because of Elon Musk. Yeah, and according to this guy, he said someone actually said that he heard it from someone that Bitcoin is a Ponzi scheme. Ponzi scheme is like MMM. Most of us, we know what happened when MMM came to Nigeria and crashed. People lost money. But some people are making money, some people are losing. And well, some people are still investing that it will shoot up, that it will exceed a certain amount, and that is when they are ready to cash out. What are your thoughts on that? Are you investing in Bitcoin? Is it reasonable to invest in Bitcoin? Whatever you say, you are basically right. Don't forget to drop your comments below. Well, let's move on to United States of America. Let's talk about Nicki Minaj. Nicki Minaj and Drake and Lil Tunchi, Lil Wayne's Seeing Green has now sold over 100,000 units in the United States. That is actually huge. And recently, Drake was seen with Michael B. Jordan. They were chilling at the courtside for the Warriors and Lakers. They were actually watching the game between the Warriors and the Lakers. You know, in the United States of America, they like this thing about basketball. They don't joke with basketball. But in Nigeria, our game is football. That is why, I mean, we see people like Kelechi Iheanacho doing that thing, and they've been doing very well, and we really appreciate people like that. I mean, they've been putting Nigeria on the world map. Our game, basically, in this country is football. We love football. Though we have basketballers in this country, but they are not as hot as what we have in the United States of America. Tonto DK dropped a message recently. Yeah, Tonto Let. She actually dropped a message. She found some fun facts about herself. She said, I am camera shy. I am an introvert. I respect all but have no fear for none. Well, never own a fake account. Never own a fake account. I think it's for cowards. I will say more to your face than anywhere else. I am medically colorblind. I see colors in different shades of gray. That is from the desk of Tontolet. What are your thoughts on that? Please don't forget to drop your comments below. Let's talk about the Federal Republic of Nigeria. The Senate proposes 15-year jail term for Nigerians paying ransom for kidnappers and bandits. The Senate on Wednesday considered a bill that seeks to prohibit the payment and receipt of ransom for the release of any person kidnapped, imprisoned or wrongfully confined. According to the bill, Nigerians who pay ransom to kidnappers and kidnappers who receive ransom risk 15 years imprisonment. Wow. The Terrorism Prevention Amendment Bill 2021, which killed second reading during plenary, is sponsored by Senator Ezeonwan Francis Onyewuchi. Leading debate on the bill, the lawmaker said the piece of legislation seeks to amend the Terrorism Prevention Act 2013 to outlaw the payment of ransom to abductors, kidnappers, and terrorists for the release of any person who has been wrongfully confined in prison or kidnapped. According to Onyewuchi, the bill essentially seeks to substitute for Section 14 of the Principal Act, a new section to read. Anyone who transfers funds, makes payment, or colludes with an abductor, kidnapper, or terrorist, or receive any ransom for the release of any person who has been wrongfully confined in prison or kidnapped is guilty of a felony and is liable on conviction to a term of imprisonment of not less than 15 years. What are your thoughts on that? Please don't forget to drop your comment below. Let's analyze this issue together. Well, thank you very much for watching Jogi Entertainment. We hope you're entertained. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like so as to stay updated with the time. Take care of yourself and have a lovely day.